Okay, we've got some ground up printed circuit board material that was sent to us. We're going to run on the shaker table, the little 2-foot shaker table. The tailings here, which is going to be primarily fiberglass, glass strands, epoxy, resin, and the plastic material. We're going to capture that in this pillowcase in the bucket here. And then next to it is the concentrates or middling trough. It's going to have mostly copper and solder in it. And then over here on the end, we have the third hole on this little table, which is our high grade number one hole. So we're going to run this material and see how it turns out. Okay, now we're really getting some pretty nice separation. Down here we've got our light material. That gray-green is the printed circuit board material coming across in the grooves. We've got a lot of the copper. And then out the longer grooves coming up under the water bar, we have mostly what I think is solder. I expect after a little bit we'll have some gold coming out as well. Now we've got some gold coming down the table, right at the leading edge of the gray material. And I think that's just going to increase as we continue on. Over here on the left, we've got primarily copper and solder. Further over here, we've got material flowing down over the grooves, the very light material. It's the glass strands and the epoxy resin, and that's going to the tailings, the waste tailings. Okay, now we're at the leading edge, right under the water bar, and down most of this, we've got a show of fine gold. Most of the copper is coming down here into our concentrates trough. There's a good view of the blue-green epoxy fiberglass material that is primarily the board material. Now here's an overall view of the separation. Right up on the far left, we've got a thin yellow gold line and then a thicker gray line right behind it. And then further to the right, you've got the separation of some of the solder and copper. And then far to the right is the blue-green fiberglass and epoxy resin material. Okay, here's the gold out of the number one hole. There's a lot of that gray material down in there. And there's a close-up look at it.
We've received our assay results back from the shaker table test we ran, and we sent our samples off to American Analytical in Osborne, Idaho. They're our assayers, they do a great job. And we did a 48 element ICP and some fire assays on the precious metals with an ICP finish. And so you can see, I'll just scan over this real quick, there's a lot of information here, but all the elements that were tested are listed there in parts per million. When we get down here to the bottom, there's the gold, silver, platinum, palladium, and rhodium that were fire assayed, and then the platinum, palladium, and rhodium were ICP finish. And so I'll go over the percent recovery in the shaker table first, and then I'll review how I ended up converting ounces per ton and parts per million to percent recovery. I have picked out the metals that I was interested in. They're listed there on the top, going from left to right, is gold, silver, platinum, palladium, and then aluminum. And down here is in pounds as well. So aluminum, copper, iron, nickel, lead, antimony, tin, tantalum, titanium, and zinc. And here along the bottom are the percent recoveries. We combined the high grade and the concentrates to find the percent recovery. So gold was 85%, silver 89%, platinum 89%, palladium 87%, aluminum 28%, but that's not surprising because aluminum's light and not worth very much. Copper 97%, iron 82%, nickel 96%, lead 92%. This was a surprising one. Antimony was only 18%. Tin 92%, tantalum 98%, titanium 78%, and zinc 89%. So those are the overall results of the shaker table test. We are very pleased with the percent recoveries. We think these can also be increased a little bit with by fine-tuning the table. And an even feed will help, maybe some adjustments to the table tilt. But so those are the overall results. Now I will go over in detail about how I calculated the percent recovery, and we can take a look at just how I got these numbers. So here's a sample calculation. We're going to find out the percent recovery of platinum from our PCB test using our shaker table. And these are the three bags that we sent in to the assay office. These are their dry weights in grams. And these are the results of the assay. Bag 1 had 0.342 troy ounces per ton. Bag 2, 0.048 troy ounces per ton. And bag 3, 0.006 troy ounces per ton. And both of these were given to me by the assay report. So to find percent recovery, we take our bag weights, our sample weights, and convert them from grams into short tons. We're in the United States, so we use short tons, which are 2,000 pounds per ton. And so there are 907,185 grams in a short ton, so the grams go away, you end up with short tons. These are all very small numbers. So then you can multiply your troy ounces per ton by how many tons your sample weighed, and you end up with true metal in that sample. So there was 1.3, I've gone to scientific notation, 1.3 times 10 to the negative 4 troy ounces of platinum in baggie number 1. And I've done that for both baggie 2 and baggie 3. And this is the key right here. This is the total amount of metal in troy ounces in all three samples combined. All three sample bags combined, you end up with 2.5 times 10 to the negative 4th troy ounces. So now we can find out our percent recovery. You take the amount of metal in baggie 1 and divide it by the total amount of metal in all three samples. So baggie 1 had 52% recovery of the platinum. Baggie number 2 had 36% recovery of the platinum. And the final bag, which was the tailings, we had 11% loss. I had recovery, but it's actually a loss because it went to waste. So when you add up bag 1 and bag 2, 52 and 36, with a little rounding error in there, you end up with 89% recovery. So that is my calculations for percent recovery. And using a spreadsheet, I did that for all of the metals. And we saw that earlier. So that is the that's how I got to the numbers. And again, I think we're really impressed with the percent recovery on all the metals we assayed for. And so I appreciate all your feedback and your support from you guys. A lot of guys have been really interested in what we're doing. So stay tuned for more videos, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks.